services.
Muli, isang magandang umaga sa ating lahat, lalong-lalo na sa ating mga participants who are mostly from the media, no? Although may mga ilan dito na from different offices. Not only those present physically during the last 2.5 days, pati na rin yung mga participants na tumutok sa event na ito through online. Okay. As we conclude this PAGASA organized seminar workshop, allow me to express our appreciation sa lahat ng mga participants for your active participation. Although ngayon lang po nakarating dito physically to join the event, but the last 2 days I'm following this activity through online, and I saw how energetic all the participants are. Dahil siguro first time na although hindi 100% face-to-face ang pagkandak natin ng seminar for the media, it's a blend with both the face-to-face and virtual activity. And of course, I would like to commend the organizing committee headed by Ms. Sharon Arvejo at iba pang mga kasamahan ko sa PAGASA who are resource persons, lecturers, and of course, yung hindi na napapagod na mga facilitators for contributing in making this activity a success. Ang information, education, and communication campaign ng PAGASA is actually one of the major trust ng ahensya. Actually, this is in line with our efforts, no, to make sure ang mga forecast and services ay madaling maintindihan ng mga users, stakeholders, foremost yung general public, especially when it comes to critical disaster information sharing and of course training activities like this. Yung seminar workshop na ito is actually a follow up activity to the just concluded observance of the typhoon and flood awareness week, kung saan ay may team na from forecast to actions towards a typhoon and a flood resilient community. Siguro timing din ito dahil nag-coincide din ito sa celebration ng National Disaster Resilient Month, yung month of July. So ang layunin ng observance ng TIFAO, yung tawag namin, is to highlight what we have accomplished recently in terms of improved forecast and warnings and the related services para maipabot at magamit more efficiently para maging more safer ating bansa. Lalo-lalo na geographically, tayo ay located sa and exposed to different meteorological hazards. And in these efforts, palaging katuwang namin kayo at kami ay taus-pusong nagpapasalamat sa inyong ginawa. Napakahalaging halaga ang ginawa ninyo. The reason why we are conducting this event in recognition of your valuable contribution in the dissemination of forecast and warnings and related information and services para maging effective, no, ito. Ang tanging layunin ay ma-minimize ang impact ng mga extreme weather events. So during the last 2 or maybe 3 days, nakita nyo, no, pinakita namin ang mga innovative strategies in line to cope up with the different weather and climate disasters in which not only PAGASA being the lead national government agency in providing forecast warnings against the hydrometeorological hazards. Isa kami sa mga ahensya ng Indrency, okay? At ang sa mga isa sa mga siguro among those innovative strategies, ito yung community-based early warning system, ang color-coded rainfall warning system, ang modified tropical cyclone wind signal na binigay ng aming mga lecturers among others. And of course, I'm proud to say na ang early warning system has been recognized by other countries. Hindi lamang ito maging ang Typhoon Committee member countries have taken notice of the pioneering good practices when it comes to public disaster awareness and response kagaya ng mga event na ito. This is because of our close partnership with the media. Hopefully, this will continue. No? As you have already know, yung July and August, ito yung masabi nating wettest months of the year. And ito yung pinakamaraming bagyo. No? And this year, itong mga buwan, we are actually celebrating sa significant commemoration ng tinatawag nating Great Luzon Flood. Maybe isa ito sa mga worst floods na nangyari, even worse than Manila Bay, almost nag-connect, no? Because of this big disaster. With this event, ito yung naging hudyat na expand ang services ng PAGASA, na introduce ang National Forecasting and Warning Flood Forecasting and Warning Services. Yung dating Philippine Weather Bureau ay naging PAGASA by virtue of Presidential Decree 78, preceded by the Senate approval of the Astronomical Geophysical Atmospheric Science Act of 1972. Expanded dahil hindi lang nakafocus sa weather. Before yung Philippine Weather Bureau, nakafocus lang sa weather, but this time kasama yung flood monitoring and warning, kasama na yung climate related services, maging na highlight or na promote masyado ang simple but complex to ordinary person ay nagiging simple, no, dahil sa India. And with that, we really truly appreciate your help. So again, my congratulations to you for completing this seminar workshop, and may the knowledge and skills imparted to you be of great help to your maybe profession sa media and your community as well. Thank you, and maraming salamat.
So thank you.